welcome to a very special edition of the Dr. J Show. It's Christmas, and we at the Ruth Institute want to share our joy with you. Christmas is nothing less than the human birth of God. We offer to you a reflection on this enfleshment of divinity. And now, here's Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse, founder and president of the Ruth Institute, with our Christmas reading from the Scriptures.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through him, and without him nothing came to be. What came to be through him was life, and this life was the light of the human race, and the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form or shape, with darkness over the abyss and a mighty wind sweeping over the waters.
And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God said, "Let us make man in our image, and let him have dominion over the fishes of the sea and the fowls of the air and the beasts and the whole earth and every creeping creature that moves on the earth."
God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them.
And God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it, and rule over the fishes of the sea and the fowls of the air and all living creatures that move upon the earth."
And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made and found it very good. Evening came and morning followed, the sixth day. Now the snake was the most cunning of all the wild animals that the Lord God had made. He asked the woman, "Did God really say, 'You shall not eat from any of the trees of the garden?'" The woman answered the snake, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden. It is only about the fruit of the tree in the middle of the garden that God said, 'You shall not eat it, or even touch it, or else you will die.'" But the snake said to the woman, "You will certainly not die. God knows well that when you eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like gods who know good and evil." The woman saw that the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eyes, and the tree was desirable for gaining wisdom. So she took some of its fruit and ate it, and she also gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate it. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. When they heard the sound of the Lord God walking about in the garden at the breezy time of the day, the man and his wife hid themselves from the Lord God among the trees of the garden.
And God called Abraham and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard your voice in paradise, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And God said to Adam, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree I commanded you not to eat?" And Adam said, "The woman that you gave me to be my companion gave me fruit of the tree, and I did eat."
The Lord God then asked the woman, "What have you done?" The woman answered, "The snake tricked me, so I ate it."
And the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this thing, you are cursed among all cattle and beasts of the earth. Upon your breast shall you go, and you shall eat earth all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your seed and her seed. He shall crush your head, and you shall bruise his heel."
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
And the angel came in and said to her, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women."
But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I have no relations with a man? And the angel said to her in reply, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God.
St. Bernard of Clairvaux commented at this point, You have heard, O Virgin, that you will conceive and bear a son. You have heard that it will not be by man, but by the Holy Spirit. The angel awaits your answer. We too are waiting, O Lady, for the sentence of condemnation weighs heavily upon us. Tearful Adam with his sorrowing family begs this of you in their exile from paradise. Abraham begs it. David begs it. All the other holy patriarchs, your ancestors, ask it of you as they dwell in the country of the shadow of death. This is what the whole earth waits for. On your consent depends comfort for the wretched, ransom for the captive, freedom for the condemned. The desire of all nations is at your door, knocking to enter. Open your womb, O Blessed Virgin, to your Creator.
Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Now this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about, when his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph. But before they had lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly.
But while Joseph thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in his sleep, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for the one conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She shall bring forth a son, and you shall name him Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled what the Lord spoke by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child and bring forth a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took his wife into his home. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds keeping the night watches over their flock. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the radiance of God shone all around them, and they were filled with fear. But the angel said to them, Do not fear, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy that shall be for all people. For this day a Savior is born for you, Christ the Lord, in the city of David. And this shall be a sign to you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly army praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of his will.
Christmas, may every child be welcomed into a loving home with their own mother and father. A merry and blessed Christmas from your friends at the Ruth Institute.
At every service for 1700 years, Christians have confessed that Christmas is no ordinary birth. The only begotten, eternal Son of God the Father, who took on our human nature at the Annunciation, has now been born as one of us. This child is light of light, true God of true God, of one essence with the Father, and who by all things were made. This was God's plan from all eternity, to join us with Himself. Ancient Christian church hymns sing, "The revelation of God is now made manifest. The preachings of the prophets have received their fulfillment. The host of angels were struck with wonder and trembled, for you, who adorned the heavens with stars, are now well pleased to be born as a babe. You hold the ends of the earth in your hands, but now you are laid in a manger of dumb beasts. Yet all these things revealed your compassion for us. Let the foundations of the earth be shaken. Let trembling seize the regions beneath the earth, for our God and Creator has clothed Himself in created flesh. He fashioned all creation, yet reveals Himself in the womb of her whom He formed. Oh, the depth of the riches of the wisdom and the knowledge of God, how unsearchable are His ways. Come, ye faithful, let us greatly rejoice in the Lord as we sing of this present mystery. For the wall that divided God from man has been destroyed. The flaming sword withdraws from Eden's gate. The cherubim withdraw from the tree of life. And I, who had been cast out through my disobedience, now feast on the delights of paradise. For today, the Father's perfect image, marked with the stamp of His eternity, has taken the form of a servant. Without undergoing change, He is born from an unwedded mother. He was true God, and He remains the same, but through His love for mankind, He has become what He never was, true man. Today, heaven and earth are united, for Christ is born. Today, God has come to earth, and man ascends to heaven. Today, God, who by nature cannot be seen, is seen in the flesh for our sake. Let us glorify Him, singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace. Your coming has brought peace to us. Glory to You, O our Savior."
Today is born of a virgin, He who holds all creation in His hand. He who established heaven sleeps in a stable. Untouchable essence clothed in swaddlings. Today is born of a virgin, He whose word the universe sustains. He who destroyed Gomorrah from Herod. The Creator has become a creature. Worship Him, worship Him, God become man. Adore Him, bow down before Him, the eternal I am. Son of God and Son of Man, worship Him, worship Him, the babe in Mary's hands. Today is born of a virgin, He who provides life for all mankind. Gave desert manna needs milk from His mother. The all all-sufficient one, hunger. Worship him, worship him, God become man. Adore him, bow down before him, the eternal.
Friends, our only action item is to ask you to reflect on this true meaning and purpose of Christmas, which is union with God. In doing so, seek Him yourself and draw closer to Jesus today. It's a relationship cultivated by prayer, forgiving everyone, confession of sin, fasting, and almsgiving. Keep foremost in your mind, the loving God of the universe is on your side. He understands what you're going through. He cares for you more than you can imagine, and He is eager to welcome you. The reality is, God is closer to us than our very breath. I'm Father Mark Hodges, and along with Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse and all your friends at the Ruth Institute, we wish you and yours a very blessed Christmas.